In this illustration, we'll analyze a situation when a man walking on rim of a disc. We are given that a man of mass small m stands on the rim of a disc of mass capital M and radius r as shown in figure. And it is saying if man starts walking at a speed u relative to disc, we are required to find the time after which he reaches the point from where he started and angle turned by disc in this time. Now, in this situation, here we can see, if a man starts walking with a speed u, then disc will start rotating with an angular speed in opposite direction to conserve angular momentum. So, here we can write, if man walks relative to disc, at a speed u and disc rotates at angular speed omega in opposite direction, then we can see if this is the disc and here we are considering this man is walking at a speed u relative to disc and the disc starts rotating in opposite direction at angular speed omega. And here we can write the velocity of man with respect to ground can be given as u minus r omega because with the speed r omega the circumference of disc is moving in opposite direction. So we can write by conservation of angular momentum, which should be zero initially as the disc and man were at rest, we can write the angular momentum of this system is zero and which is in final case can be written as m u minus r omega multiplied by r minus half capital M r square multiplied by omega. And simplifying this, we get the value of omega, which is 2mu by capital M plus 2m multiplied by r. So, this is the angular speed with which the disc will rotate if man walks at the speed u. Then we can write if man moves by an angle theta, so that disc rotates by 2 pi minus theta. That means if man moves by theta and disc rotates in opposite direction by 2 pi minus theta, then we can say man will reach the same point from where he started. Then we can write man reaches the same point on disc from where he started. And if it takes a time t, then we can use the value of t is equals to theta divided by the angular speed of man, which is u minus r omega divided by r. The same will be 2 pi minus theta divided by omega. And if we add the numerators and denominators here, this will give us the value 2 pi divided by, when you add these two terms, it is u by r. So this is 2 pi upon u by r. And this is the time after which the man reaches the point from where he started. So this is 2 pi r by u. And this is the result. And this you could have directly calculated because the circumference of the disc is 2 pi r. And if man is walking at a speed u relative to disc, we can directly calculate this time as 2 pi r by u. And you can also write, this could be directly calculated also. And in the situation, if we calculate the angle turned by disk, then angle turned by disk in this time can be given as alpha of disk. We can write this as 2 pi minus theta, and we substitute the value of time. This 2 pi minus theta can be given as omega t. So, the value we can calculate, the value of omega you can substitute from here, and t is 2 pi r by v. So, the result we are getting is 4 pi m divided by m plus 2 m. That is the result of this problem.